This week we are looking at the artist Paul Cézanne, and specifically his brushstroke and how he modulates color to create value and form. I have started with a light pencil sketch based on Cézanne's painting to plan the composition. Next, I am working with the cooler colors first. Remember, cool colors push back into space and warm colors pull forward. So even though we do not have a distant horizon or a great sense of depth in this painting, I am still starting with the cooler colors and kind of the background sky and some of the foliage first. As you work to decipher his brushstrokes, really pay attention to the direction that he lays the stroke down. This is what creates kind of the pulsating atmosphere and visual movement and flow that he has created in his landscape. You will also notice as you decode his painting how many different colors and subtle shades of blues or greens, and especially in the rocks in the foreground, there are. This teaches us a few things. For instance, one, how good of a painter he is. This subject matter, just three trees and kind of two rocks in the foreground, might seem very simplistic at first. However, as you start to work from it and paint from it, you realize how many different colors there are and how almost every other brushstroke he has mixed a subtle shade and altered the tonality, the warmth, the coolness of the color, and modulated the forms. Historically speaking, this is what makes Cézanne really stand out at this point in art history, where he is one of the early painters who really breaks down in kind of a conceptual way the formation of the painting and the development of the painting into individual facets or brushstrokes. This really animates the landscape and gives us a new, modern, and kind of contemporary effect for a pretty traditional medium, or subject matter, rather. This is also seen in other post-impressionists like Van Gogh, for instance, but Cézanne really marks a turning point in art history and influenced the next generation of painters to follow, most notably Picasso and George Braque, in their creation of Cubism. So, at first glance, this painting is really just three trees and the rocks in the foreground. However, as you start to paint, you realize it might not be as much about the trees and rocks as you thought, and it might be more about the application of paint, the brushstroke, and color. So take your time. Acrylic paints dries quickly, so that allows you to do little passages of blue or green and work out some of the grays in the rocks, pull out the red in the trees, and work at this over the next week, allowing yourself to enjoy the process and build up the painting brushstroke by brushstroke, rather than think about painting the sky all at once, for instance, or the leaves all at once. This is really built up over time through your careful consideration of subtle color changes. So you'll probably spend more time on your palette mixing color than you will actually painting on the canvas. I hope you enjoy this week's lesson, and I look forward to seeing all of your work.